Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today we're going to talk about this ribbon and what is the most easy way to model something has different depth. Are you ready? Let's get started. We are going to start roughly about this dimension, 20 by 30. I mean, you can make any size here. This is just an area that we are going to work for. We will start drawing a curve. This curve is gonna go roughly like this. It doesn't have to be pretty at first because we are going to do a lot of adjustment. So we just need to draw something like this. And you can go ahead to adjust it to make it look nicer, smoother. So I'm going to delete this block. If you do want it to be symmetrical, sometimes what you can do is you can have one and then mirror to the other side. But I would like to keep it something like that. It's not super symmetrical, so it has that human touch in there. Second, we're going to draw the profile. I'm going to use the rectangle tool with the conic corner. So with this conic corner, it doesn't have to be super big and depends on what size of a stone you want it to set. But I would like to give a cushion looking rectangle. Let's go ahead to make a copy. So I need to have that one. It's going to be copy once here, and once here on the bottom, and once here on the right button. All right, and then we need to kind of rotate it with the gumbo. And again, you don't have to worry about if they are perfectly aligned with something else. We just wanted to put it there. And we can record a history later and moving with the history is on. Next step, let's adjust the curve. I know this one and this one gonna go a little bit higher like that. We're gonna move something like this. So it's a little bit smoother. The one is cross on top of it. And the other one on the flat, we don't change it, right? And over here, those two seems a little bit too low. So I'm gonna go make it a little bit higher. And this one will be a little bit higher, even more. And because I want it to be flat to the bottom, I may wanna just increase in the size instead of just moving up. Right, so the one on the bottom is all right. We can move it up a little bit, and all of this will be changed later on if you want to. So don't worry about what exactly position they wanted to have. Right, this one I actually want to tilt it a little bit, something like this, and moving a little bit, so that will be a little bit different angle there. And we're gonna go to the surface. We have sweep one. I'm gonna pick up all of them, all of the cross section. One thing we need to keep in mind that is we need them to all align and point the arrow to the same direction. So I'm gonna use the bottom one in the middle, so everybody will snapping into the bottom, and make sure they all come into the same angle, the same direction. So the arrow facing this one, facing in on the other direction. Okay, so that look all right. Then you will have the option here. You don't have to do much about the option at this point. Make sure your record history is on. Okay, so now what we wanted to do is we need to kind of modify it because we record a history. So now we can changing the size on that. If your gumbo is not aligned to the object, you could just go ahead and click on this and align to the object. So that way that allow you to stretching with the gumbo. So let's go ahead to make them a little bit bigger this way. And again, I wanted to pick up this curve and stretch a little bit. Right, so right here, this may not be a good angle because it does kind of caving a little bit, and this one as well. I wanted to rotate in a little bit this angle, right? And then you can kind of play and tweak with it until you get the form you like, right? So we are going to do a Lamo tweaking here. You can kind of moving in if this is like too too much, too big of an opening for you. So they kind of play with it. The reason I'm doing this way is I can see the real time, how they are twisting, changing, so I can sizing up and down and everything. Not only about the cross section, you can also change the curve in there. So if I select the control point, I can kind of moving in like this, and that is helping to changing the form as well. All right, so we can keep tweaking until you like it, and that's how I get my ribbon. And after that, you can cap it and just trim the ending off. Then you will get something like this. I hope you like the video. Please like and comment and share my video and click that little bell next to the subscribe. Thank you, and I'll see you next.